I mean, who, you know, hears sirens and runs out with the toy guns?
Coop, Tang, I need you to separate. Schumann from FID's on his way. All right, you know the rules. Separate corners until after the debrief. Tang, let's go.
See you later.
When you saw it wasn't the suspect?
I radioed for an RA unit, and I immediately tried to stop the bleeding.
Kid has a record. 3 months in juvie. Broke a teacher's nose, you believe that? You want some coffee or something? Something to eat? Come on, man. I hate babysitting as much as you hate being babysitted. But that's the rules. At least put me to good use. Stupid kids running around with toy guns. When are they gonna take them damn things off the shelf anyway? I mean, how the hell are you supposed to tell the difference between that and a real Sig 9mm from here?
Cooper, we're gonna be a while. We'll talk back at the station.
My car's out front.
The lawyers of the Templeton family called this morning, and they are interested in your offer to split the inheritance.
Oh, my gosh. You have no idea how bad I needed to hear some good news.
There is just one outstanding issue. The family started cataloging the estate to determine how to divide the assets, and it appears there's a necklace missing.
Oh, that's not missing. Marla gave me that necklace as a gift.
Great. We'll need to return it for appraisal.
I don't have it anymore. I sold it.
You sold it?
Right after she passed. I needed money for college tuition. Is that a problem?
Miss Wilson, our entire case hinges on the fact that you were closer to that woman than her own family.
And I was.
Frankly, the fact that you sold the necklace so soon after her death, it looks very bad. If they're able to make it look like you were only after Miss Templeton's money, you'll never see a cent. I suggest you track down that necklace right away.
Name? I said name.
Ron Mexico.
I want to hang out with a guy named Ron Mexico. Hey, you want to come watch me bust up a meth lab?
Hell yeah, Ron does.
Well, let's do it. Folks, I'm Detective Barker. Please have a seat in the sterile holding area over here. If you need medical help.
Jackson. My daughter.
Ma'am, please. We'll be with you in a moment. Just take a seat.
They kidnapped my daughter.
Come on.
That look weird to you?
Yeah.
Play it again. Right there. She says something.
Why are they doing this?
What do you think?
I think I'm gonna go talk to the mother again.
A moment prior, she's cowering in fear. Then, suddenly she stands, and they stare at each other for nearly 10 whole seconds.
Now, I'm no psychologist, but I'd say given the proximity, they seem pretty comfortable with each other.
Well, that could mean anything. You have no idea the emotional hell she was going through at that moment.
I think they know each other. What?
It adds up. Body language, the way they talk to each other, 10 seconds of visual recognition.
You have got to be kidding me.
A dozen people in a vault, your daughter's the only one chosen to empty the cash drawers and escort the courier from the armored car.
They grabbed the last person to go into the vault. That just so happened to be Cassie. You show me a video of these bastards sticking a loaded gun into my baby girl's face, and then you try and tell me that she's working with them? Are you crazy?
We'll talk about this later. Please excuse us.
I'll wait for your call.
All right. I want you to alert every emergency room in the area to be on the lookout for an African-American girl, 18 to 25, with a sprained ankle or a broken leg.
Oh, wait a minute. You don't actually believe what she said, do you?
My grandfather was the same way. You know, one second he'd be sharp, next second he'd be floating off to another planet.
Not gonna hold up in court.
Thank you, doctor.
What do we got?
Got a female resuscitated with fluid and oxygen. Clearly ischemic changes on the 12 lead. Sending her down to the cath lab now.
Well done, Young. I got it from here.
360 going again.
We
We've been on him for 45 minutes.
360, one more time.
It's clear. Over, Pragen.
Come on, Kevin. Come on, Kevin. Come on.
I'm calling it. Time of death, 10:55. It's gone, Drew.
Doctor.
I'm sorry.
Hi, my name is Hank.
Hi, Hank. Melanie.
I'm Bill.
James.
This is Joy, and I'm...
We know who you are. Victoria Chase.
I got addicted to Edge of Tomorrow one summer. I got laid up. It was the year you were Honor St. Raven and her evil sister, Silver St. Raven.
And her even eviler sister, Magnolia St. Raven.
So, what brings you guys here?
Well, actually, we're on our way to Paris. Yes,
ma'am. Hi. We received a call.
I don't know anything about that.
We were tipped off about a possible narcotic situation.
Here?
Hey, Pam. Hey, I got this, okay? Hello, officers. Dwight Schrute, former volunteer sheriff's deputy. Listen, I may have inside information that someone is hiding drugs in this very office.
Officers, I reveal to you the perpetrator.
Hey, what is this?
Search his things.
Sir, can you step away from your desk, please?
Why?
Sir, please step away from your desk.
Hey, what's going on? You don't have my permission to do this.
Sir, did you recently return from a trip to Central America?
Oh, my God. There was, I went to Costa Rica for a few months.
That was legitimate. That was totally legitimate.
Check this out.
Oh, God.
That is not mine. I have never noticed
before. No, no, no.
What is going on here?
No, that's, I don't know what that is. And I bet he has nothing to do with that. Ah, that's mine.
No, Michael, no.
Yes, it's mine.
Some basil. Salad dressing, I think.
Salad dressing?
Yeah, it's a caprese salad. It's a little bit of mozzarella right there.
We got a fake tip.
Wait, I'll...